The locals eye you curiously as you round the corner into the streets of Underlane. Several of the patrons in this makeshift tavern glare at you with suspicious looks. Sunlight pours through a crystal set into the base of a hanging tower, providing much-needed light to a small garden set into the street below. A group of ruffians is shaking down one of the local merchants. Their leader turns to the guard and says,
"What are you looking at?"
Another group of surly ruffians seems intent on blocking the town. You arrive at the rally to find the courtyard in shambles. One of the attackers yells,
"We've been spotted! Don't let them out of here alive!"
Another group of attackers pours into the courtyard. More reinforcements arrive, intent on capturing the Warforged. For an instant, you think you've dealt with all of them. Then, an imposing orc enters the courtyard. He grunts.
"You don't know who you're dealing with.
You'll pay for interfering with us."
The orc cries.
"You think you've won?" he mutters. "This is just one job. You can't stop all of them. There are powerful people behind this. They'll never..."
But he never finishes the sentence. You've reached the residential complex the Inquisitive told you about. Now to find the people responsible for the kidnappings. The splintered remains of the door suggest that you may not be the only one looking for this kidnapper. The torn page you found points you to your next destination, the gate in the central tower of Underlane. Things seem strangely quiet as you enter the Underlane neighborhood. Some of the locals look up as you approach, then start heading your way. Another group of ruffians singles you out and heads your way. This area seems to be a part of the city's massive water purification system. Frightened faces disappear from nearby windows as another band of ruffians calls you out. Someone's intent on stopping you. You enter the central tower of Underlane, only to find your path blocked by even more ruffians. His comrades are dead. Thugs in ragged clothes and battered armor guard the central tower gate. Still more thugs block the passage out of the central tower area. They do love their bottlenecks. You approach the entrance to a fortified tower. Could this be the old South Fort the thugs were referring to? The door is sealed by 4 magical sockets, recently installed by the looks of them. Perhaps you can find their crests back in the Underlane neighborhood. The dank stench of sewage fills the air. The fetid water flows through the grate, pouring into the sewers below. The air grows suddenly hot, and whispers fill the area. As the fort door opens, you can hear frightened whispers ahead. You open the prison gate. Several Warforged murmur thanks as they bolt for the door, yet others just stand there, motionless. You open the gate, but the Warforged trapped inside don't seem to notice.
So, you're the ones disrupting my operations. You look so tough.
The half-orc collapses from his injuries with a wordless moan. The club's butler regards you with a skeptical eye, clearly wondering what brought you here. This club is using Soulsplit Warforged as servants, though your contact doesn't know where the club obtained them. He suggests that you search the administration building in the back of the club. Surely you'll find a written record there.
Thank you.
You've entered the administration building. Now, to search for the papers that show where the Club obtained the Soul Split Warforge they're using as servants.
Baxter notes your arrival with disdain. The administration building is reserved for Club employees only. I'm afraid your disregard of Club policies can no longer be tolerated. With that, the butler executes a crisp turn and attacks. You've caused a great deal of damage to Club property, says Baxter sadly. I regret that you must pay the price.
Baxter falls, a searching look in his eyes. You suspect that his last moments were spent wondering who would clean up the mess you've created. You're now free to search for evidence regarding the source of the Soul Split Warforged. The Club purchased their servants from something called Fathom Endeavors. Armed with this knowledge, you can start tracing the Soul Split Warforged back to their source. You hear grunts and snarls beyond the door the thugs have been guarding. The thugs ransacked this apartment while leaving all the other homes left untouched. They must have been after something specific. This corpse matches the description of David Shelby. And yet there's no sign of how he died. Perhaps there's a clue inside his apartment that points to the information he promised you. You've learned that David had a safe house hidden in a water purification plant down by the Sharn docks. David Shelby lies lifeless on his bed, yet there's still a chance you can find the blackmail information he promised you. You need to catch a sky coach, head down to the docks, and find his safe house. A single sky coach is docked nearby. Its pilot cowers before a group of lumbering thugs. She rasps.
There wasn't supposed to be a body.
The pilot agrees to bring you down to the docks. Just board his sky coach, and you'll be on your way. You disembark the sky coach at the water purification facility. A guard at the door lazily raises an arm to warn you off. You convince the guard to open the door. Now to search for David Shelby's safe house. A A giant crayfish stands near the open waterway. Oddly enough, it wears a metal helmet and holds a key in one of its pincers. As you approach, thoughts suddenly barge into your head. Huh, you don't look like an exterminator. Maybe you can help me. The telepathic crayfish asks you for help. It seems an Otiug has taken up residence nearby, and it's determined to make the crayfish its next meal. A rank odor assaults you even before you open the gate. No doubt you found the Otiug's lair. You've reduced the Otiug to an oozing pile of flesh. The crayfish scuttles over to the locked door, and you feel a tug in your mind as he beckons you telepathically. You suddenly realize that the odd telepathic crayfish holds the soul of your supposedly dead informant, David Shelby. As a final request, David gives you the key to his safe house and asks you to let him inside. A well-stocked, comfortably furnished room lies behind the locked door. The crayfish crawls inside, clacking happily. You once again feel the telltale tug of telepathic influence. The information you sought flashes into your brain. Fathom Endeavors has a secret base beneath Sharn's Harbor. This underwater base must be the source of all the soul splitters, and where Fathom is keeping the stolen souls of the Warforged. It sounds like an adventure beneath the waves is next on the agenda.
Your accomplishments, you have transcended the title of hero. There are a talented few who could teach you about what fate lies in store.